bust down Rollie for the hell of it. It's my time to shine, spotlights is my element. Fuck a plain Jane, don't insult my intelligence. I don't plan on selling it, so I don't see the relevance. You niggas having porn shop nightmares. I'm light years ahead of niggas, even on a light year. Dom Perignon, stain the laces of my ears. Born poor, but I'ma die rich.
I think in the grand scheme of things, it depreciates the value of journalism. I'm saying, like, this is authentic, right?
None
here.
Of this shit is journalism. Well, I don't know why people keep saying that. None of this shit is journalism.
So what is it?
Well, Mecca, you're a journalist.
Yeah.
Mecca's a journalist. He writes editorials and shit like that. Right. But the shit that we're doing, this ain't journalism, bro.
Part of it is, though. Because you still feel like you have a certain responsibility. It's
two
not
things can
journalism
be true at the same time.
There's just, I wouldn't say journalism, but it's responsibility to the culture.
To quote Nori,
if you have integrity,
to be a journalist, you have to be a whore. No offense, Mecca. But you have to be a whore. You can't play sides, you can't play favorites. It's all about the story. So all the things that you didn't put out,
right,
you would have put out if you were a journalist.
That's not being a whore. Your first job is to tell the story.
Right.
Right? That's the first job of a journalist. Tell the story and tell an honest truth. Gather the facts. That's not being a whore. Would be switching the story up for everybody who walks through the door, treating everybody different.
No.
I'm going to let you tell your... I'm going to tell...
When I say whore, I mean like your man that you have a good relationship with comes on the show and you ask him some bullshit.
What's the first thing I said to
Nori? For the sake of the story.
What was one of the first things I said to Nori when we went and did Drink Champs? Mm. One of the first things I told him.
Yeah, check that episode out, by the way.
Please.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah.
What's the address here? Because Jasmine's going to come meet us here.
We don't want to say it on camera. Let's not say it on camera. Let's just type it in our phone. Let's just type it in our phone.
Drop the address.
Yeah, let's do that.
Talk about
no, he got it. He got the address already.
Jeez.
There's security.
They ain't playing with you niggas.
What I said to Nori was, one of the first things I tell all my subjects is, I'm not your friend. When you're sitting down and we're doing this interview, we can be cool. Mm-hmm. I might even be cool with you outside of this, but when we're doing work, I'm not your friend. Don't expect me to treat you any different. I'm going to tell the story. And if you have a problem with that, you need to leave now. Or you need to be very careful about what you say, because I'm here to do the job, not be your friend.
Okay.
When we get into this media space, the story becomes more entertaining than anything else, than the truth, than the facts. And people would rather hear some bullshit than the facts. Mm-hmm. So you got to be like, we're not doing journalism up here 9 times out of 10. We're making it entertaining.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I'm not about to start bullshit.
I'm not a journalist. Don't come at me with that journalist bullshit.
Yeah, well, and it's not that, but I you do feel like when
so
you take things out,
bullshit.
You have a responsibility, because you also don't want to see things happen to people. You don't want to see somebody incriminate themselves. You don't want to see somebody say something while they're drunk that they're like, oh shit, what did I say?
Right.
That's honor and integrity
so
as
it's
a
not
person.
Journalism.
That's not journalistic integrity. That's him being a decent human being.
Like, right. I've been on Drink Champs and guest hosted and they've taken things out because the person has been like, oh shit.
You shit-faced drunk. You said some wild shit.
I kind of feel
like... take that out.
I kind of feel like their Drink Champs should get the grace to do that because part of their platform is giving you so much alcohol.
Right.
I think that needs... I think you should consider what somebody's saying when you've gotten them tipsy and sloppy. The tipsy. Even just lit. I think you should... maybe this should come with some editing because we're getting people to say shit that they would not say.
Otherwise, there'd be a better show called Cocaine Champs.
Should
be
wait
for it.
That should have been what?
So I shot Kanye in the lens. That's why he's walking with a limp.
And that's why I beat up Drake. You know, he's crazy.
The way this shit is going, wait for it. Like you said, people just...
But this is what I'm saying. Like it keeps going to the level where there are personalities out there that their sole purpose is to tear other people down every time they open their mouth.
Right.
Because it works.
Like, what I really like is when I do an interview and people listen and they're like, or watch it and they're like, I like that person even more now. Or I feel like I know them even better. Too. Like, I just interviewed Ari Lennox and I love her. And like, I enjoyed that interview so much because I appreciate the fact that she'll come and do my show and she'll talk about things in a different way than she will with anybody else. Mm-hmm. And that means a lot to me, you know, right. because I love her as an artist. And you want people to feel like safe to come in your space
right.
and be able to say things that this might be the first time I'm saying this, but they're giving you something, you right. know, and because they trust you with it and they feel safe about it. And it's interesting still, but it doesn't have to be controversial.
Always. Doesn't always have
to it be. It doesn't right. have to be. Right.
Right.
Yeah. And so
I agree
like,
with that.
Yeah. So like even with Angie Martinez, you know, she has this Tupac that is legendary that she's never put out.
Shout out to the GOAT.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But she also, I feel like Angie is the epitome of, I don't have to have people come on here and say like some crazy wild shit. But she's had some amazing moments that have been controversial.
Right.
But it's not like that's what she does. Right. You know what I mean?
She's
and so people will go up there and feel safe enough to sit down and pour out their heart to her and talk to her, but not feel like she's trying to get a moment. Because there's sometimes when you go places and people are going to ask you the headline. They Googled you real fast and they're like, oh, shit, this is controversial. Let me ask this because I know this is about to go crazy. Mm-hmm. And people do that. Like people will.
Clickbait.
Yeah, people will do that clickbait. They will put up that headline. They will try to get those clicks by asking the most outlandish thing, which is the easiest thing to do.
Right.
Low-hanging fruit.
Low-hanging fruit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
However, it does garner a response that sometimes it's like, oh, okay, I get why they do that. But now me as an individual, I look at you in a certain light and I can't fuck with you.
But is there a difference between asking a controversial question versus asking a question that everyone that you know is watching is thinking. Other platform is asking.
It's also how you ask it. Right. You know, I think that's important too. Like to take care with certain things to know how to ask a question and phrase it where you're not trying to say it in a way that way, but saying it in a way that's like giving you an opportunity to talk about something.
Right.
That's way different than saying something that's shocking for the sake of being shocking. Mm.
It's the intent. It's the intent behind the question.
Mm-hmm. Because sometimes there's certain headlines you can't ignore. And look, there'll be times when people come up there and be like, this person can't talk about this. And I'm like, okay, I still want to make sure I'm able to ask the question. And you can say, this is not something I can address right now because of X, Y, and Z.
Right.
But I still want to make sure that I'm responsible as my, you know, in my responsibility.
Like, pause. We had Dwight Howard on the same day.
Super Bowl.
How did it go for you?
Now you asked the question.
Yeah.
We had a private conversation and decided not to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So.
And I feel like also in that situation, it might have been different, you know. I don't know, it's weird. Cause I saw our guy, Coach PR, and how he asked the question. He was just like, yo. People want to know.
Yeah, he was very
direct. He just asked it in the beginning.
Yeah, right to it.
To it.
Right.
And, you know, and this, but I feel like when we asked it, it was not necessary. You know, he's addressed it before.
Right.
And so it was hard to not bring it up. And let me tell you something. People had an issue even with how I asked it. They wanted me to go hard and really, like, probe.
Yeah, yank them out the closet. Yeah. Grab them
and I'm not doing that. You know, I'm not doing that.
Right.
But I just feel like there was a lot. There's a court case that was going on. You know, there are things happening. And so
there's a reason to get the information.
There's a reason. Yeah. Right. It wasn't just like, so what's going on in your personal life? It was more like, look, there's this case going on now, but previously you've said this. Is this what you want to? And we've seen how this case has been developing.
Right.
The greatest feeling in the world was holding my own gun. I'm hypertensive, but all my decisions been wholesome. My independence had me flipping on siblings I stole from. Said I'm just big and loud. Well, half a pound is my silent treatment. I punched out plugs I could've stopped from eating. Jackie Gleason on the TV while his mama's sleeping. That plate was made, or he got that Chick-fil-A like she Polynesian.
The fucking niggas do to me though. So I stand there blinded while my jewelry glows.
That's all it is. You just, in the end, you can do it.